The U.S. Army's Extended Range Cannon Artillery, ERCA, gun fired an Excalibur shell to a range of 43 miles, or 70 kilometers in a test. As per the U.S. Army, the gun now holds the world record for precision strikes. The Army conducted the test at Yuma Proving Ground in Arizona. Brigadier General John Rafferty, who's in charge of the effort, told a small group of reporters in a teleconference immediately following the test, "I don't think our adversaries have the ability to hit a target on the nose at 43 miles." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Extended Range Cannon Artillery, ERCA, gun with Excalibur shell could transform the deep strike capabilities of the U.S. Army. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. This has been accomplished using a special gun and an optimized propellant. The ERCA cannon consists of an M109A7 Paladin Integrated Management PIM howitzer chassis with a longer barrel. The 39 caliber gun tube has been replaced with a 58 caliber 30 foot or 9 meter one. Viewers may note that in field artillery, caliber refers to the tube of the gun barrel as opposed to the diameter of the bore. The 155 millimeter diameter of the barrel is multiplied by 58 to determine the overall length of the barrel, which is equal to 29.49 feet. A longer barrel permits the expanding gases triggered by the shell powder to act upon the projectile for a greater period of time. ERCA uses a new supercharged propellant formulation designed to increase pressure inside the barrel. These two combine to provide increased velocity and range. In this test, the U.S. Army took 3 shots. Rafferty said that each munition fired during the event had slight design differences to address how best to design and prepare the round to absorb the high pressure and force of being fired at 1,000 meters per second from a gun tube. The first shot, due to the winds, fell short by roughly 100 meters, which Rafferty said sounds like a lot, but is closer when considering the munition has to travel 70,000 meters. The U.S. Army knew the first shot would come up short due to wind, but wanted to take it anyway in order to learn from it. In the second shot, the U.S. Army had modified the hardware configuration and experienced a hardware failure. Specifically, the U.S. Army added an isolator for the inertial measurement unit, which is essentially a shock absorber, to counter the pressure spike in the chamber. Rafferty stated, "We did have some concerns with the survivability of that." The third shot hit the target and provided the desired outcome. As per Rafferty, the success proved that the service is getting closer to dialing in on the right balance between propellant, projectile design, and other factors that play into achieving greater distances. What was consistent was the propellant configuration, he added. "So we got that propellant configuration, I think dialed in really close down, which is great." Colonel Tony Gibbs, the Army's program manager for combat artillery system, explained that it took about 1.5 years of testing and analysis to determine whether the Excalibur projectiles could withstand harsher environments. Gibbs added, "So through a number of tests and analysis, we determined what muzzle velocity is required, what chamber pressures the projectile can withstand, and so all that came together in today's test. We fired it at the right propellant combination to provide the right muzzle velocity to achieve the range." The M982 Excalibur is a 155mm extended-range guided artillery shell, developed during a collaborative effort between the U.S. Army Research Laboratory (ARL) and the United States Army Armament Research, Development, and Engineering Center (ARDEC). The Excalibur was manufactured by the prime contractor Raytheon Missile Systems and BAE Systems AB. It's a GPS and inertial guided munition. A new variant, known as Excalibur S, has laser guidance, which makes it capable of seeking and engaging moving targets. The S version has GPS and a semi-active laser seeker to get after mobile land and maritime targets in GPS-contested environments without a loss in range capability. Raytheon stated that the Excalibur Increment B projectiles used by U.S. Army and U.S. Navy can be upgraded with the S capabilities. Sam Denneke, Raytheon's Land Warfare Systems Vice President, had said in a statement, "Using artillery to engage moving targets gives soldiers more flexibility. Artillery is typically used to hit stationary objects, but Excalibur S expands the capability of artillery on the battlefield. Excalibur is used to minimize collateral damage for targets beyond the range of standard munitions, for precise firing within 150 meters or 490 feet of friendly troops, or when firing in a straight line from the launching cannon is limited by terrain. It has a multifunction fuse that can be programmed to explode in the air once it hits a hard surface or after it penetrates inside a target. One Excalibur projectile can accurately hit an intended target that could require the use of between 10 and 50 unguided artillery rounds." Though artillery is seemingly old-fashioned, they are and will continue to play an important role on the battlefield in the foreseeable future. An artillery barrage will keep the enemy's head down and provide opportunities for the infantry to advance undercover. Artillery barrages have also been known to have a physiological impact by demoralizing the opponent. It's cheaper and faster than air support, and is now way more accurate as compared to the old days. ERCA almost doubles the range of existing U.S. Army howitzers. According to the Army, the current M109A7 Paladin self-propelled howitzer can send Excalibur rounds to 39.3 kilometers, or 24.4 miles, which has now been extended due to the special gun and an optimized propellant. The U.S. Army is trying to extend artillery ranges so as to counter the adversaries, especially Russia, which is developing its own long-range artillery system. The idea is that the ERCA cannon would be able to fire and take out targets from a position that will be beyond the strike envelope of enemy systems, and this test is a step in the right direction. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.